Who was Lise Franck, or Lise Franc? Jacques Lise Franc de Saint-Martin was born on April 12 in 1787 and not, as stated on Wikipedia, on April 2nd in 1790. And this is a very good example how people just copy other people, because in many, many orthopedic and radiological scientific reports you will find the wrong birth date. This is a very good example where someone just writes the date and 1790 and then gives the reference, and in the reference would actually have been the correct date. Now, you might argue that the birth date that I have might also be the wrong source. However, I put the link to the homepage down below. You can go and check for yourself. The correct one seems to be the birth date which appears in the Napoleon Guide, and this has been confirmed by a guy named Mr. Alain Chappé on the basis of Jacques Lisfranc's baptismal certificate. That seems to be the correct birth date anyway. So he was the son of a physician, and as such he spent a lot of time with his dad and obviously observed him practicing medicine, and that's how he got interested into the subject. He studied medicine in Lyon and then later on went to Paris and was an assistant to Guillaume Dupuytren. And this is also another famous person that we might cover in another video. And soon enough, he became at least as good as his master, so that's either very good for him or very bad for his master. Because he was probably a difficult character, they became enemies. So Dupuytren and Lisfranc became enemies, and that is why he never became a proper professor at the Faculty of Medicine in Paris. Between 1813 and 1814, he was in the French army and was at war. After the war was over, he went to a private practice in Paris, where he wanted to enjoy life, I assume, after the war. And there it is said that he rescued a magistrate who fell from the horse. And this dude then invited him to join the Faculty of Medicine at the Hospital of Pitié, or the Hôpital de la Pitié, where he soon became the chief of surgery, and in 1826 he became the director of his own department, where he taught classes in clinical medicine. He was a very creative physician, I would say, because he used the stethoscope to diagnose fractures and also diseases of the uterus, which seems rather unlikely. He later then became one of the most famous French surgeons and gynecologists, especially at the time. Anyways, he died in 1847 in Paris and is buried in the Cimetière du Montparnasse. And here we have some images. Here we have Lisfranc's grave, and apart from his bust up here on the top, there are two bronze bas-reliefs on either side here, which were added later on or after refurbishment. And the first one remembers his work on the battlefields of Leipzig in the year 1813. And you can see him standing here in the middle, checking on a soldier here, doing something like a body check or something like that. And you can see all these soldiers with their uniforms and stuff like that. So very interesting. And then on the other side, we have another bronze relief to remember his clinical teaching lessons at the Hôpital de la Pitié in Paris. And it's not surprising that there is a foot here in the middle on the table, and all these students are very, very interested. I'm not sure, this guy's sleeping, this one probably as well, and I really don't know who this is. So what are Lisfranc's contribution to medicine? We all know, especially as radiologists, the Lisfranc joint and the Lisfranc fracture or Lisfranc injury, which are named after him. He described amputation of the foot through the tarsometatarsal joint or articulation in 1815, so after the War of the Sixth Coalition, which was a war between Austria, Prussia, Russia, UK, Portugal, Sweden, Spain and some German states, where they defeated France and eventually drove Napoleon into the exile on Elba. Anyways, this amputation was used to treat forefoot gangrene from frostbite, especially at the Russian front where it was cold and people suffered from frostbite. And Lisfranc was widely known to be able to perform this surgery in less than 1 minute. In addition, during the Napoleonic era, soldiers on horses frequently fell down with the foot still trapped into the stirrup. And this led to a vascular injury of the forefoot with necrosis, which eventually required a Lisfranc amputation. So Lisfranc himself described amputation, but not the injury. And it's not clear whether he invented the amputation himself, as some sources write, or whether he only observed this surgical technique at the Russian front and then came back after the war and described it in his book 1 year later. So that would be something like a fellowship in Russia. Then there is the Lisfranc ligament, which is a strong ligament between the second metatarsal bone and the medial cuneiform bone. And this ligament is just named after him because it's in the region of the Lisfranc joints. No deeper meaning here. And then there is Lisfranc's method, which is a surgical technique to remove the rectum in cancer patients. He was the first surgeon to successfully remove a rectal cancer using this transanal approach. And then there is the Lisfranc tubercle, which is less known than Acton's tubercle. And if you don't know what Acton's tubercle is, I recommend go check this video here in your upper right corner right now. Anyways, the Lisfranc tubercle is not well known either, and it's a tubercle of the first rib where the anterior scalene muscle inserts.